Kyle Sloan. This is my friend David Corneli. And what we're going to look at is a series of choke positions and controls. Now, obviously, you're probably not going to work these in sequence in a competition environment. What this does is it's going to build a facility for you when you end up in various hand placement conditions, that you'll have something that's very familiar that you can go to. And if you don't have something quite right, then you'll have easy opportunities to go either up, what I call upstream or downstream from the position that you're at. So if you'll go ahead and lay down, Damon. We'll start this off from, just as a general rule, we can start this from a straddle position, like the mount, or we could start it even from Tate Shihogatami here. If you're starting it from Tate Shihogatami, what I would recommend is letting your thumb enter on the bottom side here and bringing this around. So you could be going immediately to a Katate Jime position. Likewise, you can enter with your other thumb, Nami Juji Jime, and affect the choke. From here, I just want to turn my palm over. So now I'm in Kata Jime. Boom. Turn this one over. Gyaku Juji Jime. Boom. I'm going to let this slide down. Okuri Eri Jime. I could also let this, from this pulling down position, I could also let this hand turn over and push this through. And this is sort of a Kazuri Kataha Jime position that we might run into. From here, extract this. I'm going to enter over the top, grasping the opposite lapel. I like to keep this control as I cinch this. You'll notice I'm getting the head turn here. So when I cinch that, I'm into a nice Katate Jime very quickly. From here, underneath, grabbing the sleeves, Sode Garuma Jime. So, like I said, obviously you're not going to work these. This is not like a go to the tournament, do A, B, C, D, run through six or seven chokes, but it does give you a facility that you recognize the different hand positions and are able to affect changes if need be.